All right, good morning and welcome. Before we take the opportunity to enter into worship of our God, we just want to take a few minutes to review with you some of the things that are happening, make you aware of some events that are taking place and some things that have happened with our church family. Just kind of get up to speed as we continue to come in and prepare for our time of worship. My login for this didn't work yesterday, so I'm having to go a little bit by memory, but the slides will help us out. First of all, just want to, if you didn't see the messages or if you're not on our newsletter list, this week we lost a couple of our long-term members here at College Park Church, people that are maybe some of the pioneers of this congregation, a couple of people that lived to a quite an elderly point in life. And we just want to acknowledge these members who have passed away and extend our condolences to the families. First is Rose Connors, who was, I believe, 95, yeah, it says there, 95 years old, passed away last Sabbath. So we want to remember the Connors family. And also Cecil Milner, who I believe was somewhere close to 100, if not 100, or 99, maybe coming up on 100. So a couple of our very long-term members passed away. And we benefit here as a church now. We benefit from, you know, the path that they've set before, the leadership and the involvement and just setting the foundation for what our church is today. And we can be thankful for these people who have passed away asleep in Christ and have the hope of a resurrection when Jesus comes back. But let's remember these families in our thoughts and in our prayers. All right, some things that are happening. One is the Kingsway College Preview Weekend. This is a big weekend for Kingsway when students from grade 8 to 11 who are prospectively thinking of coming to attend Kingsway College can come here to this area in Oshawa, can come and hear the band and the choir and see the aerials perform and the strings and all of the different things and have an opportunity to learn about what Kingsway offers. So if you know someone, or if you have someone in your family who are prospective high school students, this would be the weekend to come on April, two weekends from now, April 26th through 28th, and really get immersed in the Kingsway experience and find out what's going on so that there can be a preparation to enroll for the fall. So a big event happening, and a part of it on Sabbath happens here at College Park Church, and we get the opportunity to benefit from all of those things along with our school community next door. For us here at College Park, we have secured an amazing weekend at Camp Frenda. This is a weekend I know from being at Willowdale that Willowdale used to own. We used to have this weekend, and at some point we, in my opinion, foolishly gave it up, and somehow College Park has got it. So I'm kind of glad I'm here at College Park. This is an opportunity that's being led out by our family ministries for us to go and spend some time at beautiful Camp Frenda on Lake Rosso. The registration is available. You can sign up and register and then pay. I've registered, I still need to pay. We hope that you will plan on this. It's a long weekend. It's Friday through Sunday that we can be there. And take a look at our website and take a look at your schedule and see if you can come join us in beautiful Camp Frenda, where we can continue to worship together, but do so in a little bit different setting from what we do right now. We're also happy to announce that we're going to be able to start up our College Park Church Kids Soccer Club again this year. And that takes a lot of work and a lot of volunteers. So we're announcing that this is happening. It's going to be happening over by our elementary school. And of course, right now we're at the point, a lot of the planning has already begun, but we're at the point where we're calling for the volunteers that will be needed to help keep this thing running and keep everybody organized. We need some volunteer coaches, and I don't even exactly know what all volunteers we need, but we need volunteers. So talk with the church office, talk with Pastor Rui, or talk with Julie Columbi. They're the ones that are doing the organizing on that, and find out how you can help out. And if you're a young kid who would like to be in the soccer club, keep that in mind so you can make sure you get signed up and get a space. Our health ministries department has sent a video which is actually connected with another big event that's happening at the end of this month, the last Sunday of this month, which is the Earth Summit. that the Ontario Conference is putting on. If any of you attended the one a few years ago, there were thousands of people there at the International Center. A very good opportunity to share what we believe about origins, about God as our creator. It's part of our first angel's message, right? About worship God the creator. This is a very well done, very professional opportunity to invite someone to come. And it's kind of like a convention style, kind of booth style thing where you can come and just have different perspectives, different opportunities to get information on how God is our creator. That's what we believe, that God created our world in 7 days and that he is the origin of life. And so this is just pointing out, this little video is going to point out one aspect, just one of many, many booths, which is the health aspect. So we'll watch that video now. So 2 weeks from Sunday, hopefully you can make your way to Mississauga, to the International Center over by the airport, where we've had camp meeting for many years in this conference, and have the opportunity to take in the Earth Summit and hopefully invite someone to come and join you as well. As always, we want to remind you that the best way to keep up to date with what is going on, not only locally here at our church, but in our elementary school, at Kingsway, in our conference and beyond, is to sign up for our newsletter. If you haven't done so, don't wait until Jesus comes to do that. Please sign up so you can be informed and aware of what's going on. Today is our Adventist Education Sabbath here at College Park Church. We are thankful for the association we have with our school, College Park Elementary School. It's been a lot of work that's gone into getting this worship service together. A lot of children, as you can see, and their teachers and parents, and different people involved in getting this together. So we're thankful for that. Thank you, Mrs. De Silva, for putting this together. We have the opportunity to highlight something important to us today, and that is the component of Adventist education. So we are going to listen to Kyle play some music, which will give us the opportunity to thoughtfully get our minds in tune to prepare to worship. So let's do that now. Thank you.
Thank you, Kyle. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to College Park Church today. For some of you, it may be your first time worshiping with us, and we're so glad that you've decided to join us. We want to extend a warm welcome to everyone watching online, and especially our viewers from the Pioneer Apartment Homes. Today, College Park Church has graciously allowed its namesake, College Park Elementary School, to lead out in worship. For those of you that do not know, my name is Michelle Da Silva, and I am the principal of College Park Elementary School. This year, the Ontario Conference is celebrating 125 years of Adventism in Ontario. And CPES has been a part of this legacy since 1912. That represents 112 years of planting the seeds of faith in Durham Region in boys and girls. College Park Church is our longest standing constituent church, and it has partnered with us since its official inception in April of 1960. You know, while researching the CPS's rich history, I came across a picture from 1949 that I found particularly interesting. At that time, CPS was a two-room school, grades 1 to 8, with 66 students and two brave teachers, I say. Two teachers, grades 1 to 8. One of the teachers' names was Violet Prouty. That struck particular interest in me because at the age of 93, Mrs. Prouty came back to my grade 2 classroom and ran a reading group twice a week in my grade 2 classroom at the age of 93. I remember telling my husband and my kids to kind of like funny eyes that when I grow up, I want to be like Mrs. Prouty. I want to be 93 and be able to be doing what I love in the capacity that I love in the bite-sized piece in a school of my choosing. And I want to tell you that at 93, she still had it. One look from her and those rambunctious second graders would fall into line. They would pick up their books or refocus on the Scrabble, which was a game that she so loved and was fostering a love in them. So one historian says, and writer, sorry, says, we have nothing to fear for the future, lest we forget how God has led us in our past history. So I stand here today, the teachers stand here today, the students stand here today on the backs of those that stood before us. Their faithful volunteerism, parents that could dedicatedly put their children in our school, those who prayed for us through the years. We stand on their backs. We stand on the backs of faithful volunteers. My oldest volunteer currently comes in every week, is also in her 90s from this church. She's shy, so I won't say her name, and volunteers in our hot lunch. We have faithful volunteers that coach our sports clubs, and faithful, bless them, the PTA leaders and all their happy helpers. We so appreciate them. So today is about remembering where we have come from, remembering where we are, remembering the goodness of God and the faithfulness of you, our constituent churches, and our parents that support us. I invite the ladies that are doing our call to worship to come forward.
I invite you at this time to stand for our call to worship. Psalms 57, verse 9 to 11. I will praise you, O Lord, among the peoples. I will sing to you among the nations, for your mercy reaches unto the heavens and your truth unto the clouds. Be exalted, O God, above the heavens. Let your glory be above all the earth.
O God, you are our God. Earnestly we seek you today. Our souls thirst for you. Our whole beings longs for you. Because we have seen you in the sanctuary and beheld your glory, we can respond. Lord, your love is better than life itself, and we declare that our lips will glorify you. We will praise you as long as we live, and in your name we will lift up our hands to do your work. Lord, we will be satisfied if you feed us. And we will now sing praises to your name. Please remain standing for opening prayer.
Please bow your heads for prayer. Dear God, come to us as we gather here today. Live with us, Lord, through our worship and our prayers. Help us to hear you, help us to know you, and help us to be able to be with you today and always.
Thank you for allowing us to meet here today and for everyone present. Please guide us, especially be with those leading out so that the word of God can be shared in a meaningful way. As we explore the theme, Rise Above, we invite the Holy Spirit to be present in everyone's heart and in this church. In Jesus' name, amen. Please remain standing for our opening song.
Good morning and happy Sabbath, church. Please stand for our, you may be seated and please join us in worship for our first song, Here I Am to Worship.
Please be seated.
Down into darkness, open my eyes.
Our second song will be You Are My All in All.
This Sabbath, College Park Church recognizes the impact Adventist education, and specifically College Park Elementary School, has had on children in Durham Region since 1912.
1912? Wow, that's 112 years.
Yes, and College Park Elementary School is a part of a much larger school system and that started in 1853, when the first church school for Sabbath keepers was opened.
Today, worldwide, there are more than 110,000 teachers, 2 million students, and 9,500 schools that represent the goal of true education to restore human beings into the image of God as revealed by the life of Jesus Christ.
A portion of College Park Church's budget goes to support CPES. We are grateful for their partnership with us in ensuring that boys and girls in the Durham region have an opportunity to get a quality education and meet Jesus each day.
We want to specifically thank Pastor Godzo for being the grade 8 class pastor, Pastor Rui for being the grade 5 class pastor, and Pastor Martin for being the kindergarten and grade 1 class pastor. We also want to thank each one of you for generously supporting us through your faithful offering to your church budget. Thank you for modeling for us that we are blessed to bless again.
Today's offering is dedicated to Hope International. The Hope Channel shares inspiring stories of the transformational love of Jesus Christ with people all over the world by producing high-quality Christian content to reach new audiences in innovative ways. To date, the Hope Channel has reached over 80 countries with the Adventist message. Let's make 2024 the most impactful year yet in sharing hope in Jesus with people everywhere.
And I'm just going to jump in before we invite the deacons up. The offering today is for Hope Channel International. During our offering collection, we usually show you a video. Today, we're going to show you a video, which is one of the ones that Elder Vicente sent us. We didn't get to show all of them in preparation for our Hope Channel Canada. So when you see that video, it's going to talk about Hope Channel Canada's beginning on March 1. Yes, we are aware that this is past March 1. But I think the message that he gave in that video about how we can be partners with Hope Channel is something that goes well beyond March 1. So once we're collecting our offering and you watch that video, it was talking about Hope Channel starting. It has started in Canada, and we want to continue to support it, and this offering is one of the ways that we can do that. All right, so call them up.
May the deacons please come forward. Let's pray. Dear God, please bless this offering. May it be used to share the good news of Jesus with men, women, boys, and girls around the world. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Hello, friends. For the last several weeks, I've shared with you that a new hope is coming to Canada. And now the time has come. This coming Friday, March 1st, Hope Channel Canada officially launches. We'll share with our country that there is more to life, and it is found in Jesus. And we cannot do it without you. In every video clip, I've invited you to become an agent of hope. But what is that, you might ask? An agent of hope is someone who yearns for others to know that the more they crave can only be found in Jesus. If this is you, I invite you to join us today as an agent of hope. Together we can share with Canadians that there is more to life and that they can find it in Jesus.
Wherever possible, I encourage you to kneel with me, or you may bow as we pray. Loving Heavenly Father, we come to you this Sabbath morning on our knees with heads bowed, to lift up our voices, our minds, our thoughts to you. We come, Lord, as a group, as a church, to acknowledge your presence, to give you thanks and praise and honor and glory. And as we do, O Lord, we ask you to forgive us where we have failed you, and that you may accept our humble presence in this your church. We therefore come, Lord, and ask that you will direct everything that is done here today, that you will speak through, sing through, and use each one of us to bring honor and glory to your name. May your Holy Spirit so guide us, so direct us, that we will give praise to you, and that each one of us, as we go from here, will receive a blessing and be encouraged to live for you more and more each day. This morning, O Lord, we want to thank you for bringing this school, College Park Elementary School, for the past 112 years, so successfully to this point in time, when we could come together in such a happy way to give you praise and thanks. So therefore, we ask that you continue to bless the school, bless this church as it supports the school. Bless each parent as they in every way give their all to support the school here in this community. May they, Lord, realize that this is a sacrifice and it is something that we need to do to train up our children in the way they should go, as you've instructed us, so that when they're older, when they grow, they will not depart from the truth. So, Father, thank you for the opportunity we all have to bring our young ones, our children, our church to you day after day. Thank you for the service here today. May you speak through the pastor and whoever presents the message, that we will truly be encouraged and that they will be blessed, and that their words they speak will be a word of encouragement to us. May the students, as they present, that they will truly present what you have them say, as they were trained to do. Thank you, God, that you'll be with us. Bless this church. Bless everyone here today. Bless every home represented. And may we continue to give the praise, the thanks, the honor, and glory, and see you in our lives day by day. We thank you for hearing our prayers. In Jesus' holy name, amen and amen.
Good morning, church. Every year at College Park, we choose a new theme, and this year our theme has been Rise Above. And students and staff have been learning that with Christ, with Jesus, we can do all the things that he asks us to do. And so it follows that our core text in today's scripture reading is from Philippians 4:13, which says, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. At this time, we're going to have our children's story. And our story today is going to be presented by the grade 8 thespians. We have a skit for you. And you will see a kid, who begins to pray to ask God for things, and he finds his prayers answered in unexpected and terrifying ways. So we're going to invite the children of the church to come up, and we're going to ask that you sit up front on the pews so that we can use the stage for our story. So come on up.
Hey, Fred.
We've been learning a lot about prayer these past few days, haven't we?
Yeah, a lot.
I've been trying to pray more every day. How about you?
Not too much.
Well, don't you have any prayer requests left to ask God for?
No, I don't really know what to ask him for.
Well, you can ask him for anything. God likes to hear from you, and he wants to answer your prayers.
Yeah, right. Maybe you'll think of some things to talk to him about today.
Well, I'll see you later, Billy.
All right, bye, Fred. Okay, I'm gonna try and say a prayer right now. Dear God, could you please, please, please make me rich? Give me all the money in the world so I can buy a new bicycle I want and lots of other cool things. Amen. Should work.
Hey, you kiddo.
Oh, hey, Dad.
I want you to mow the lawn today, okay?
Right now?
Yes, right now.
Well, what's in it for me?
You can have this.
Whoa! How much money's in here?
$10.
What? Only 10?
Yup. I've been trying to get rid of the pennies I've collected as a kid.
Oh, great. And it's all mine now.
I know, it's pretty impressive, eh?
Yeah, Dad. Really impressive.
All right, then. You get to mow that lawn?
All right.
Good job.
I'm gonna do $10. All right, let's try this again. Dear God, could you please, please, please give me a girlfriend? I can't stand being the only single seventh grader anymore. Please, God. Amen.
Hey, Billy.
Oh, hey, Mom.
I was wondering, why don't we do something fun together today?
Just you and me?
Yeah, let's do something fun together.
Like what?
I don't know. How about this? Let's go shopping.
Shopping for what?
We'll start at the mall and follow the sales signs. Come on, it'll be fun.
All right.
Okay, I'll get ready in an hour.
All right, that gives me enough time to mow the lawn then.
Sounds good. See you in a bit, sweetie.
All right, bye. All right, come on, God. Please, please, please make me more popular. Make me super popular. Make me the most popular kid in school. Amen.
Hey, there's Billy, let's get him.
Yeah.
Whoa, guys, it's just me, Billy.
Play with us, Billy, please, please, play with us.
But play what?
I've got an idea.
What?
Let's play catch the Billy.
Yeah.
Oh, no. No, no. God, I know you love me, but please don't give me anything else. You're killing me, God, killing me. Amen.
Oh, hey, Billy.
Hey, Fred.
I heard you praying that prayer. What was it about?
Let me tell you, I did some serious praying today, but every time I ask God for something, it's like he ignores me and does the complete opposite, just to torture me.
How so?
Well, first I asked God to make me rich, and then my dad comes along telling me to mow the lawn for him. After, I ask God for a girlfriend, and my mom comes telling me to go shopping with her. Finally, I ask God to make me more popular, and a pack of wild kids comes and chases me around the place.
Wow, that's really weird.
I know. It's like, God isn't answering my prayers at all, just for the fun of it. But it's not fun. It's driving me crazy.
Billy, I don't think God's ignoring your prayers.
You don't?
No, I think God's just giving you what you need. Not exactly what you asked for.
Really?
Yeah, like when you ask for money, but instead you got a job from your dad so you can learn the value of hard work. And when you ask for a girlfriend, well, Billy, how old are you anyways?
11.
Well, God knows you don't need a girlfriend now, but what you do need is to spend some more quality time with your family, especially your mom.
I guess.
And when you got attacked by that mob of wild kids, I think God was just saying you could be a good role model for them.
Yeah.
So, Billy, keep praying and let God answer your prayers as he sees fit.
All right, Fred.
Well, I'll see you later, Billy.
Bye. All right. God, please continue to give me what you know is best for me. But please, no more wild kids for at least a few days. Amen.
Before we end the children's story today, I'd like to leave you with two verses. Matthew 6, verse 11, give us our daily bread. And Philippians 4, verse 6, do not be anxious about anything, but by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God.
The message of this story is that Jesus teaches his disciples to pray about their daily needs and concerns and to trust in God to take care of them. Prayer isn't a license to get everything we've ever wanted. Prayer is a way of personally aligning ourselves with the holy nature and perfect will of God. We pray to him knowing that he loves us like a father and will do what's best for us, even though it doesn't make sense at the time.
What do you pray most about? How can you show others that you trust God to take care of you? What does prayer do to the person praying? How can you expand your prayers to include broader concerns, deeper conviction, and more people in need?
Let us bow our heads and close our eyes for prayer. Gracious God, give us faith to pray for our daily bread, the needs of others, and the concerns of the broader world around us. Help us to trust in your loving grace to take care of us and give us a bigger and bolder vision of your will for us and our lives. Amen.
The end.
We want to invite all our CPS students to come and sing our special music, Fly, just like we had practiced it. Everybody from kindergarten all the way to grade 8. If you are not a student at our school, you can go back to Mommy and Daddy. And if you are, you can join us on the stage here. Thank you very much. Okay, just let's have the kindergartens in front.
Yeah, yes, yes, yes.
The kindergartens, grade 1, 2, 3, you know what grade you were in?
Can you find a grade 2 line? Just go to the grade 2 line. There's where you're not after you go and tell me. No. Thank you.
So kindergarten first, then grade 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The bigger kids can go to the back.
Thank you.
Can you come? Come, close. You can do 2 lines. Bring up, up. Come up, please.
Okay, same size.
be seated. Thank you.
Thank you very much. That was a great song. I love that song. I was listening to it in the middle of the night this week, packing boxes in my house, and it's a great motivational song and a very good message. So thank you. Thank you to the students. And how about the grade eights, those actors? I actually was already aware that the grade eight class can act up. I've learned that spending some time with them this year. But thank you very much for all of the students and what you've done. So some of you will be happy to know that this is not the time when there is going to be a sermon. You can just hold your amen within and just thank God for answered prayer like we heard about. But this is a time for us to worship, and this is a time when we are focusing on something very important that we do in our church, and that is we put a lot of resources, a lot of money, a lot of energy and time into Adventist education because we believe it is important. We believe that it does give the opportunity for young people and families in our church and in our broader community the opportunity to add to the educational component the faith aspect that is important to us as Christians. And so today we have the opportunity to have four families who are going to share a bit of a testimony, some parents and also a grandparent, a testimony about what Adventist education means to them and the blessing that it has been and the commitment that it is. For myself, I had the opportunity to enter into Adventist education in grade four when my family moved here to this community, to Oshawa, close by here. And I was able to spend 5 years at College Park Elementary School and then 5 years at Kingsway College and 3 years at Canadian Union College and then something like 3 years at Andrews University. And that was a blessing in my life. I have appreciated Adventist education. It's been a consideration in where I choose to live and move for my own children. And today, as you listen to these testimonies, I hope that you will take this as an opportunity to hear something that is a testimony from the heart, from God. We're here to worship God. This isn't just about our school. This is about God and how He works in our school. And the people that are going to share today give us an opportunity to reflect on that. For those that are sharing, I don't think you're going to have the same bank of paparazzi here with cameras filming you. We're going to start off with Yandri and Julie, and we're going to listen to some families share and take this opportunity to think about what God is doing in our school and in our families.
Morning, church. Happy Sabbath.
This morning, we will be sharing a little bit of what has been our experience with Adventist Christian education. Our first experience with Adventist schools started with Ileana, our oldest daughter. We had moved to Brampton, and upon doing some research on what would have been her homeschool, we realized that the reviews weren't the greatest. It was at that moment that we made the decision to enroll her at Crawford Peel campus.
We have heard about a Christian education, about the school that the church have. We also met some people at the Spanish church that have attended there and they have sent their kids, but never crossed our mind to send our daughter to the school. Until Ileana start attending the school and she will come back home and she will be starting telling us how they will start every day with the worship, how they will pray, how they will sing every day, and before every class, how they will read the Bible verse and how they will pray.
The summer before her eighth grade year, we made the decision to move to Oshawa so that she could finish grade eight and move on to Kingsway College, and our daughter Natalia would start grade one. And just like her sister, she too would come home and tell us how they would do worship every morning, how they would pray before each test. Then a few years later, Nayeli, our youngest daughter, would also start, and she too still comes home excited to show us the new worship song that they are learning at school.
As the time passed by, our older daughter went to university, and she will come into us, how she will miss when the star will start, how she will miss those prayers. Those prayers that they have at the school, how she will miss those Bible verses. And she also shared with us how the environment was different, how the language, the relationship, the stuff that people talk and how they act, it was different than what she was experiencing until that moment on the school. The book Christian Education reads, "If ever we are to work in earnest, it's now. The enemy is pressing on all sides like a flood. Only the power of God can save our children from being swept away by the tide of evil. The responsibility resting upon parents, teachers, and church members to do the part to cooperate with God is greater than the world can express."
I specifically remember one of the first Sabbaths after they had started school here at CPS and walking in here and seeing their teachers and their classmates. For me, or for us, it felt like everything had come together, home, school, and church. When you hear and read the news of what's happening in the world, we are at peace, knowing that they are in the right place and with the right people, and in a place that we also know they are teaching them the values and principles according to our beliefs.
I know, and I don't want to say that the school is perfect and there is no problem, because we are all human. We are all working to get better every day, to get to grow as human, as Christian, as they are learning every day. Also the teacher, part of the staff, everybody is trying to make the school every day a better place for them to be. Christian education also reads, "The Lord would like the church school as an aid to the parent to educate and prepare the children for the time before of us. Then let the church take hold of the schoolwork and earnest and make it what the Lord desires to be." I would like to thank all the members of this church for the support that they have for the school. Let God help us and help the teacher at the school to guide our children so they can develop their character, so they can be ready for what they will have to do in our world, in the future, in their life here, but also be ready to go to heaven when Jesus comes back.
Amen.
Good morning, College Park Church. Thank you, Pastor Godso, for the opportunity to share our testimonies on Adventist Christian education. Thank you, Julie and Gendry, for coming up first, because it gave me a chance to calm my heart rate. Since I'm here alone, my husband and I were asked to share together, but since he could not be here this weekend, I will carry on as best as I can. Let's bow our heads for prayer. Father, may the words that come from my mouth speak of you and speak for you today. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. I was jolted by a thought one day. Where would I be had it not been for Christian education? It surprised me to see how much God used Christian education to guide my life events, starting as far back as my maternal grandparents. What surprised me even more was how Marvin, my husband, and I shared the following. Our maternal grandparents became Adventists because of Adventist schools. They were there not as students, but as employees at some point. This changed the course of their lives and the lives of their children completely. Their children, our mothers, worked their way through Adventist schools. They met our fathers, who also worked their way through Adventist schools. And together, they served at Adventist educational institutions and the church their entire careers. Marvin and I both have one parent who is an educator. Both Marvin and I spent much of our growing up years on Adventist school campuses. We attended Adventist schools and universities. We also met each other at an Adventist university. Many years later, we started our life together and started our family also at an Adventist university. When we came to Canada, we always made it a point to live near an Adventist church and Adventist school. 10 years ago this year, we moved from our apartment at Bathurst and Finch, which I know Pastor Godso and Pastor De Silva would be familiar with. And we moved here to Curtis, again, because of Christian education. That is why our children today are enrolled in CPES and at Kingsway College. The question, why Christian education, has been posed to me, not as a question, but more as a challenge. It may seem like we have been following a family tradition of Christian education, but the true answer to this question points back to God, who changed, guided, and blessed our lives and the lives of our parents through Christian education. We want that narrative of God's leading to continue in our children's lives, and what better place to encourage this than in a Christian school? I will illustrate this from the vantage point of the front desk of CPES. The simple facade of CPES belies the complexity of 180 human beings, teachers, staff, and students, excluding parents and visitors that interact each day. I would like to highlight the word human beings because it speaks of different strengths and weaknesses, different home, ethnic, religious backgrounds, different personalities, different stories. It means that we are sinners, sometimes a little more often than we are saints. But the beauty of this diversity is that it is turned into unity because of Christ. Every joy, every triumph, any good that comes out stems from the knowledge that it is not I, but Christ. This comes about through prayer. The teachers and staff pray for each other and their families every morning. Parents, you cannot imagine how much your children are prayed for every day and how much you are prayed for. I once told my husband, we are raising children in a very different and difficult age. We need every bit of help that we can get. What better place to get this than in a Christian school? I came across Deuteronomy 11 while I was preparing for this talk. This is the chapter where God presents Israel with a list of blessings and curses to choose from. This is my summary of this chapter. In verse 2, it says, And know ye this day, for I speak not with your children, which have not known and which have not seen the chastisement of the Lord your God, his greatness, his mighty hand, and his stretched out arm. Verse 7, but your eyes have seen all the great acts of the Lord, which he did. Therefore shall ye lay up these words in your heart and in your soul, and bind them for a sign upon your hand, that they may be as frontlets between your eyes. And ye shall teach them to your children, speaking to them when thou sittest in thine house, when you walkest by the way, when thou liest down, and when thou risest up. Back to the question, why Christian education? Because we want that narrative of God's leading to continue in our children's lives. In a place where our children can see, hear about, and experience God's leading for themselves, and one day hopefully choose to make him their God, and in turn speak of his leading in their lives to their children and to their children's children. I will end with a text, as Michelle often does in our board meetings. Psalm 79:13 says, so we thy people and the sheep of thy pasture will give thee thanks forever. We will show forth thy praise to all generations. The NLT version says in a simpler way, let each generation tell its children of your mighty acts. Let them proclaim your power.
Good morning, church. It's a pleasure to be here with you today. Claudia and I, my wife, we owe everything that we are and everything that we have accomplished to Adventist education. Since from a young age, we studied at UNASP, which is the Adventist University of São Paulo. UNASP in São Paulo is an oasis inside the concrete jungle, which is the busiest city of Brazil. At UNASP, Claudia and I studied from first grade to high school. And we learned not only the courses needed to pass the equivalent to the SATs, but we also learned music, painting, and sports. We developed everlasting friendships. We traveled representing the school all over Brazil and to some international places as well. But above all, we learned about Jesus. Just like several other families, we moved from Toronto to Oshawa so that our children could also benefit from Adventist education. CPES, too, is an oasis in the GTA. We understand that true education means more than the pursuit of a certain course of study. It means more than a preparation for the life that is now. Ellen G. White says that true education prepares the student for the joy of service in this world and for the higher joy of wider service in the world to come. True education and true wisdom come from the source of all creation, our God. It is written in Proverbs 2:6, for the Lord giveth wisdom, out of his mouth cometh knowledge and understanding. The education that we teach at home to our children and the education that we look for in a school is the education that enables the harmonious development of the physical, the mental, and the spiritual powers. Our God's ambition is for us to inspire our children. and for CPES to inspire its students with principles of truth, obedience, honor, integrity, and purity. These principles will make them a positive force for the stability and uplifting of society. And because these principles become a living power to shape the character through the acquaintance with Christ, all of us, students of Christ, are training for the course that embraces eternity. Ellen G. White, in her book Education, page 30, says, "In the highest sense, the work of education and the work of redemption are one. For in education, as in redemption, other foundation can no man lay than that is laid, which is in Jesus Christ. And as parents and Seventh-day Adventists, let's continue to support CPES and Adventist education so that our children are educated for life eternal. Amen."
Good morning, church. I don't know if Mrs. Kwan is here. Is she here? She's not here. She's here somewhere. But if she is or if she isn't, someone can share this. I just want to share something. Give her a shout out. Mrs. Kwan taught both my girls at two different Adventist schools. She taught my older daughter at Peel Adventist Elementary, and then she taught my second daughter at College Park. And I think next year she'll be teaching my granddaughter. And on top of that, she's my husband's favorite teacher. So love her, she's even not, even when she's not around us, she still lives in her home. I will hear mom, I remember those days, "Mom, that's not what Mrs. Kwan say, this is the way we're supposed to do it." So, you know, she was always right in my home. So thank you, Mrs. Kwan. All right, let us pray. Father in heaven, thank you so much for the blessings of our Adventist school and our teachers. We want to thank you that you've blessed us with these amazing teachers that are there to help us to care and to develop our children so that they are prepared for your kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen. Ah, I wanted more than a school for my girls. I wanted the academics, yes, but I wanted for my girls to know the heart of Jesus. I wanted my children to be around teachers and faculty staff who are going to treat them as family. Teachers who are going to love them through the eyes of Christ. A school where the teachers would pray for and pray with my children. I wanted teachers to see my children not because of the color of their skin, but through the blood of Jesus, through the blood of his skin. He bled for us. And so when they see him, they see that my children, they would see Christ. These simple truths would be instilled in my girls at a very young age. The school shared my beliefs and gave my children hope, a hope for a better tomorrow. I value the relationships my children have developed with friends and with teachers. I value the church that supports our schools, Pastor. Not everyone can afford the Adventist school or Christian education. And I understand that because I came this close to pulling my daughter out. And I'll share my story. When Taylor was in junior kindergarten at Peel Adventist Elementary, I went through separation and divorce. It was hard. I was struggling. I was from a two-income family, now to a single-income family. And I would check all my finances, and I could pay all my bills. But I could not provide
enough food for our table. I thought of pulling her out of the school, but she was doing so well despite as to what was happening at home. She was babbling in French. I couldn't even speak French. And she was only 4 years old. And then she was reading at a grade 5 level in junior kindergarten. If this child loved school, wanted to be there, and I come to realize that the school was helping despite what was happening at home. She had joy outside of the home because of the teachers who were supporting and who was loving her. So one morning during worship, I came across Proverbs 16, verse 18, which says, "Pride goes before a fall." So I decided to humble myself, and I went to the church, and I went to the community service leader, and I explained what was happening with me financially and what I was going through. For the next few weeks, the church provided a food basket. I was able to feed my child and keep her in Christian education. The value is not only in the school, but with the church and the home. When all three are aligned, we can raise a community of young people who will continue to share the gospel truth. A group of young people who will share hope. Hope that is a much needed word that is lacking within our community today amongst young people. I thank the teachers and the staff of both Peel Adventist Elementary and CPES for the values they've instilled in my children. And, sorry, the values they instill in my children and now my grandchild. We continue to pray and support your gifts, and we thank you for helping us to raise our children, for them to continue to see Christ, not just at home, but at school. So teachers and church, thank you.
I just want to make it clear that she took 5 of the 7 minutes that you gave unto us, Ms. De Silva. Thank you so much. We bless the Lord. Amen. I will actually be wrapping my testimony so as to, just kidding. All right. So there were so many uncertainties at the beginning of my daughter Fallon's life. I was a young mom, unmarried. I had no real job at the time, no real idea of what I was going to do, and not even much idea of how I was even going to get this child out of my belly. But for some reason, I knew that I was going to send my child to an Adventist school. And looking back, I now think I understand why, and a lot of it has to do with my experience in Adventist school. So reason number one, Christian education sows seeds of relationship that surpass community and become family. I went to Peel Adventist Elementary back when it was in the bottom of Mississauga Church, the church that I was attending at the time. And till this day, my best friends are friends that I met in those classrooms. Till this day, my confidants and people I go to for advice or questions are the teachers that taught me back when I was a tiny person. And today, I see those same kind of lasting bonds forming in Fallon's experience through people like Mrs. Williams and people like Fabi, Emily, and Mariella. Yeah, yeah. And little Matthias and Adrian and Phoebe. These people have not only opened their homes to us, they've opened their hearts. And that's the difference you get with Christian education. Your child isn't just walking into a classroom, they are walking into the hearts of every single staff member, every volunteer. Don't sit there and cry, then I'm gonna cry. Good Lord. Someone please move her from the front. And they are also walking into the hearts, little do they know it, of every other student on campus. Reason number two, where I can't be present, Christian education can. It was still and is, it was and is still so important to me that the time my daughter spends away from me, at least in her formative years, is saturated in Christ. It needs to be saturated in His love and His kindness and His compassion and His grace. I, like most working parents, spend my whole day at work, you know, and sometimes the hours are longer than they should, but that is why it was not negotiable for me. I was and still am determined to give my daughter a firm foundation, but being a working single mom, the few hours in the evening, they're just not enough. And I know that there will come a day when Fallon will be out there on her own, and she'll meet the world and all of its opinions and its options and its obstacles. And this is gonna be a day when my arms and my voice can no longer defend or guide her. And she's gonna have to make her own choice based on what's inside of her. But I like to believe, and it gives me great comfort, that because of my mom's sacrifice, choosing Christian education for me, which kind of pushed me and led me to choose Christian education for her, I strongly believe that there will be just enough Jesus in there to help her do the right thing.
Amen.
Our theme this year is Rise Above. And since September, we've chosen a theme song that has guided us throughout our classes, our assemblies, as a school in general. And the song that we're going to sing is our theme song. It's called Ready to Rise. So we ask our praise team, along with everybody else in our school, K to 8, if you can make your way back up on stage one more time, and let's show the church, CPC, our theme song. Let's close the gap. Let's close the gap, people. I forgot to mention that this song also incorporates our memory verse or our Bible verse, which is Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength.
When I feel alone, lost in the crowd, I'm just looking for Gabriel and Danny Bertoni. I see what Daniel, come listen. And Gabrielle, if you want to come forward for our closing prayer. Come right in the middle, boys. Okay, perfect.
Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for being with us today, for the message, and for blessing us. Help us to faithfully serve you with all our hearts until you come. We thank you for the Sabbath day and the opportunity to worship you.
Please give us the fruit of the Spirit and help us to be good examples to everyone we meet. And make us holy. We long to join you in heaven one day. Please take us all safely today. In Jesus' name, amen.